Hi guys, have you ever found yourself in a situation where you needed to showcase multiple items in a scene, but liked the idea to do so? Perhaps you simply animated them and showed them in a straightforward manner. Well, what I want to talk about today is how to use a different and creative idea so the animation would look more professional and well-made. Before we get right into it, if you're also interested in After Effects and motion graphics, and you want to learn motion graphics tips for free, be sure to subscribe to my channel and enable notification, so you won't miss out on new videos. Now let's get right into it. Well, what I want to do is turn such a scene into this scene here. To do that, first of all, I delete the animation of these items. I make them the same length. I arrange them in a line. Like this. Let me like the character com so it won't be selected. The layers should be in 2D, so I disable their 3D option. And then I select them all, and by pressing Ctrl-Shift-C, I put them in a new comp. I select the new comp. In the Effects and Presets panel, I choose the CC Cylinder effects and apply it to the comp. As you can see, as soon as I apply this effect to the comb turns into a cylinder. I go to the rotation section and rotate it like this. I set it to minus 10. And I set this to 7. And then under shading, I set the ambient to 100 and the fuse to 0. So the comb would be shown without any shades. After that, to make the radius of the cylinder bigger, I can increase radius. However, this results in the layers stretching, and surely enough, I don't want such this. So, to make the radius bigger and not to make the layers stretch, I open the comp, I hit Ctrl K, and I double its width. So, I type star and 2. So, the width of the comp would be double. And then I can place the layers randomly. After that, I back to the main comp, and as you can see, the radius of the cylinder is much bigger. Okay, the next thing that I need to do is place the character in the center of the cylinder. For that, I duplicate this comp. I place one of them under the character layer. Then in the render option, I choose inside. And for the upper comp in the render, I choose outside. As you can see, the character is now in the center of the cylinder. And to rotate the items, I open the rotation, I use the Y rotation. And to make the Y rotation of both comps rotate simultaneously, I open the lower comp effect. I open the other comp as well, rotation. And I parent the Y rotation of the lower comp to the upper comp. I do the same for the other rotations as well. So once something is changed in the upper comp, the other one would change as well. I do the same for their positions as well. After that, if you pay attention, once the upper comp is selected and I change the Y rotation, as you can see, both comps rotate at the same time. And to give it a 3D look, I select the second comp. In shading, I set the ambient to 50, maybe a bit more, 75. And I also add the camera lens blur effect to it. and I set it to 3. I increase the fuse a bit, and I change the light as shown so it would look better. And then I can animate the Y rotation. And until here, it would rotate once completely. To improve the 3D effects, let's work on the shadow of these items. For that, I duplicate the lower comp. I name it Shadow. I delete the camera lens blur effect. I select the layer and I set the render to full. I unparent the X and Z rotation. And make it look like this, 90 degrees. And I decrease its radius so it will fit in the scene. After that, I add the fill effect and change its color to black. And then I set the opacity of the layer to 30. After that, I make the layer 3D. I open its rotation and I set the X to minus 90. And then I move it down here, like this. I also increase its scale quite a bit. And to make the shadows of this part where the items are farther from the ground, I use the gradient ramp instead of the fill effect. I move this locator here, and this one here. And I change its color to the color of the background, but a little darker. And to make the shadows more realistic and thinner, I add the matte choker effect to it. I increase choke. I also increase geometric softness, so it will look much better. If you are interested in making animations and motion graphics in After Effects, and you're still at the beginning of learning or even a professional, I recommend you to enroll in Motion Hero course. Because in this masterclass, I talked about all the necessary topics that a pro motion designer needs with lots of practice and projects. So you have the fastest path toward perfection and you wouldn't have to do the same mistakes as I did. So enroll now and take your skills to the next level.